Dave and Danielle, just remember that today is the microcosm of your union together. It's going to be a beautiful day. You're going to be surrounded by people that love you, your friends, your family, and if you can just soak it all in, enjoy the day itself, then just know that it's going to be like this for the rest of your lives.
Today is August 9th. My daughter is getting married today.
I've been waiting 9 months for this to all materialize. We've been planning and planning, so to have it all come together to finalize the big day, it's at this point, if it's not done, it's okay. We're not going to worry, we're not going to sweat. Planning wasn't stressful. Danielle and I had a blast. The last 3 weeks we've been running. She moved out of her apartment the end of July. Dave moved out of his apartment the end of July, and he's now living where they're going to be living, and she's been here with us, and every morning waking up with her to a cup of coffee has been just a mom's dream. You know, I've had her back for 3 weeks, and I got attached again, and now she's going to be leaving again, and it's all wonderful.
Surprisingly smooth for morning of a wedding. I've been in a lot of weddings before, and this never went that smooth. Each little puzzle that fell into place was just felt so right.
I feel good. I'm glad it's finally here. I've been waiting so long for this, and I feel like all of the stress has kind of vaporized this morning, and it's just rolling and happening.
My little Danny, the love that she had was being in the marching band, and she once told me, she said, that she hoped that one day her future husband would have that experience to be in the marching band too, and Dave was. The first time I met David, Danielle brought him over for Easter dinner. She told me, she says, he's real shy, so don't overexpect him to open up to you. It takes him a while to open up to you. And I said, no problem, I won't pressure. I was at the island fixing the food, working on some things, and he just came right in, leaned on the counter and says, hi, and I'm David. And I said, well, hi, you know, and introduced myself, obviously, and I see these two together, and there's no doubt in my mind that they are meant to be, that they are a match made in heaven. We love him dearly. He knows we do. He's the son, and I tell him all the time, you're the son I never had.
So right now, we are at my apartment, or actually I should say our apartment.
He's been saying he's not nervous, but he might be a little bit by now that the date's here, but I think he's probably doing just fine.
I feel excited. I am ready. I feel like this has been a long time coming. I'm sure a lot of us are just ready for today to be here. My closest friends are here. All my groomsmen are here. My dad's here. And we're just kind of taking a moment to reflect on the day, you know, think about what's going to happen today, just kind of have a moment with each other.
I met Dave when I first came to the University of Michigan, and he's been one of my closest friends since then, so it's been about 7 years. So knowing that he picked me to be the best man, I was definitely honored, for sure.
My head is stuck in the clouds. She begs me to come down, says, boy, quit fooling around. I told her love the view from up here, warm sun and wind in my ear.
So for all the groomsmen and ushers, I got all of them personalized cufflinks. I wanted them to have something that was meaningful. My dad, I got him some steering wheel cufflinks because he loves the road, he loves to drive. My best man, Drew, I got him some DC token cufflinks because he's from DC. My cousin Michael, I got him some Darth Vader cufflinks. He loves Star Wars. Manny, my oldest friend, I got him some Lamborghini cufflinks because that was his favorite car growing up. Chris, I got him some propeller cufflinks because he's a pilot. Christian, and he's very athletic, so I got him some bike chain cufflinks. Taylor, I got him some baseball cufflinks. Pinto, I got him some computer chip cufflinks because he's a computer programmer. And Andrew, he brews beer, so I got him a bottle opener and a bottle cap cufflink. And Danielle's dad, I got him some camera cufflinks because he's an amateur photographer. So they're all individualized. And I got myself some Texas cufflinks because I want to bring a little bit of where I'm from to the ceremony.
The dress trip was, we started out at David's bridal. Everything was very pretty, but it wasn't the wow factor that we were looking for. So we left a little discouraged, and we went to lunch. I said, why don't we go see if Dior is available? Let's go look at their dresses. That's where I got mine. So we called them, and they said, well, you need an appointment, but you're lucky. We have an opening today at 2, and it was 1:20. So we were in Plymouth, took off, went down to Dearborn.
I saw it in the window, and I had no idea that it was going to be the one. I just knew that I was excited to go into that store.
Tried on a bunch of dresses, and every one that she brought out, I kept looking at the one in the window. I says, I want to see that one on her. And she says, oh, okay. So she went and got a dress out of the other window, and it was pretty. And I said, it's that one. I want to see that one.
And as soon as I tried it on, it fit perfectly, and it's hanging upstairs right now. I'm so excited to put it on.
I did not go shopping with Danielle to get her wedding dress. She wasn't allowed to take pictures. So she had her mom sort of incognito snap one out of the side, and she sort of cut her head off. But I figured since the dress was in,
and she obviously to me was Cinderella, just gorgeous, prettiest thing I ever saw. But we both knew that was the dress.
I thought of Danielle, she was awesome. The first time I met her, I was nervous when I met her and everything, and she's just awesome. She's just an awesome lady. And I know that David loves her a lot, and I know that she loves David a lot.
We adore Dave, we love him.
I think he's got a great heart, and I think he's gonna take care of my little girl.
What I think is going through Dave's mind right now is he's just overjoyed and ecstatic, and he's just soaking it all in, and there's no way that he's nervous because Danielle is fantastic, perfect for him.
I can't believe his day's here. A couple weeks ago, it just seems so far away.
They're just perfect together, so I think he's just looking at it and going, what is going to happen right now is I'm going to get married to the woman of my dreams, and I couldn't be any happier.
Now that it's finally here, I couldn't be happier. When we first started looking for a ceremony location, we initially just wanted a church. We wanted a small church, a small chapel. We had photos at the big house planned, and one day her dad said, hey, what about having a ceremony there? And we said, no, that's too much, too crazy. He goes, just take a look at it, just go ahead. So we set up a meeting with Katie, and she walked us through everything. She showed us the locker rooms, you know, the home, the visitors. She showed us, just walked us down the stadium, under the field, just walked us around through what the ceremony could look like. And then we got back in the car, and Danielle and I looked at each other, and we just said, this is actually kind of a lot cooler than we thought.
I think getting married at the big house is a phenomenal idea.
When I found out, my jaw just dropped. I mean, Michigan Stadium, the big house, that is incredible. I'm on top of the world.
Decided to go for it, you know, because we both were in the band. We both had marched on that field, you know, dozens of times, and we couldn't think of a better way, a better place to celebrate our lives and celebrate getting married than on the field where we spent a lot of our college lives there.
There is no grander place to get married. I mean, you really feel like this is it.
In no way does it overshadow the wedding. In fact, it complements it super well because both of them together, their wedding, their union, as cheesy as it sounds, I guess it's just a metaphor for their love together. It's big, it's large, it's larger than life, so why not have it at the big house?
And just seeing her awe, you know, in her splendor coming down the aisle is going to be so over the top with it.
I don't know, I have words to describe that. It'll be a flood of memories of me watching her come through that tunnel on that field and me being able to go onto the field today with her be a very special.
My favorite part of today will be looking at the groom's face. That's my favorite part of any wedding. Everyone turns and looks at the bride, and I always look at her, and then I always look back at the groom, because his face tells it all.
As soon as I see Danielle, I just don't know how I'm gonna feel.
I think he's gonna go crazy. I think that his heart is just gonna light up.
As soon as she comes on the field, all the worries, all the stress is just gonna melt away.
I'm so excited to see my son get married. In a way, I'm sad because he's gonna be living here in Michigan, but that's fine with us. We see that he's gonna be happy here and he's gonna be okay.
The ceremony itself was breathtaking. I think that it was everything that she wanted it to be and more. There was barely an open seat in the house.
I now get to pronounce that you are a husband and wife. That's it. And I know y'all have been practicing this for a long time. David, kiss your beautiful bride.
I can't wait to walk back up the aisle with her.
When we go do photos, we're gonna first do photos in the big house after, and then we're gonna go to the law quad, just because it's gorgeous. And then we're gonna go to Ashley's, which is where Dave and I used to play trivia, and that's where we started to date.
David is a good boy. He's a strong young man. I know he loves Danielle a lot. He's just an awesome kid. He's my son. He's awesome.
He knows her inside and out. He's always looking for ways to surprise her or to do nice things for her. They are just such a perfect couple.
You can just see in their faces how much they love each other.
I'd say my favorite thing about them is that they're just supernatural together. They're always joking with each other. They're always poking fun at each other. They both like the same things, cracking the same corny jokes. And at the end of the day, I mean, if you can marry your best friend, which is, you know, what they are, they're best friends, then you've got it made. You're perfect. You're golden.
We had a reception at Kensington because my bridesmaid, Natalia, she got married last summer, and so she had given me a whole list of reception venues, and she put it on there. She goes, you know, this didn't work out for me. They were booked. She goes, but you should try them. They were really nice. There were a couple of options we were looking at, but nothing was really working for our date, and I was just getting frustrated, and it was the last one of the day. It was a long day, and the only date they had open was August 9th, and Candace was fantastic. Everything worked, and I was like, this is where we need to be. We need to have it here.
Song we're gonna be dancing to at the reception is by Straylight Run, and it's Existentialism on Prom Night. We were at a friend's wedding. This wedding, they didn't play very many slow songs, and you know, they might have been cheesy or might have been not something that her and I just would have danced to. I took her back to her apartment. While she's in the bathroom, I just brought out my phone and I started playing it. I said, I owe you a dance. So we started dancing to it, and that just kind of became our song, our thing. So we decided that'd be a good, our first song.
I'm gonna be doing the mother-son dance. My son doesn't dance very well, so I don't know how that's gonna go.
Our song that we will be dancing to will be Butterfly Kisses. We knew several years ago that that would be the song that we would use on this day.
About them is that they read like a book left to right, and it's always on its way to something more amazing.